All right, I'm gonna do some SMD soldering on a prototype keyboard PCB. And I'm just gonna film the whole process. Okay, these are all the SMD components right here. Okay, so let me just reposition the camera and then I'll do a close-up of the video. Okay. Okay, here's the PCB I'm going to be working on. It's a custom GeekHack 60 PCB. And then while I'm holding the camera, this is a poker and this is a pier. They're pretty much the same size. And here's the rest of the PCBs. I already shipped out 5. And there's another about 10 to do. Okay, so let me reposition the camera and then I'll do the whole process. Okay, here it is. I'm not sure how this is gonna work out because the camera is really close and it's a bit in the way. Okay, so first I'm gonna do hot air, but then before I can even do that, the controller has to be tacked on there so it can stay put. So just put a little bit of solder and just do one pad. Okay. Now just align everything. And then just remelt that one pad so that it holds onto one of the legs. Okay, that should be good. And then I would do the opposite side, but I'm at a really bad angle right now, so I'm just gonna do this side. Let me align it a little more first. Okay, now I'm just going to put solder paste on all of these pads. This part is pretty tedious. I think there's a total 200 and something pads. Okay, now just put it on all the small pins of the controller. The needle I'm using, it's probably too big. It's either 22 or 24 gauge. Oh, this is really hard because I'm at a bad angle. Alright, normally when I do this, I would apply paste to every pad before I put the components on. But since the camera's already in place, I'm just gonna do this area and then solder it on and then do the rest. Alright, so now the fun part. Now you just reflow the solder with hot air. And the tension from the solder paste kind of keeps it in place for now. See, when it melts, you can kind of see it wiggle around. All right. I do see some bridges right here that I'll have to fix with an iron. All right, so that part's about done. Okay, time for the next part. I'm gonna do the USB part with the rest of the components around this area. This part doesn't have to be exact, because when you reflow the solder, it'll just go to the right place because of the solder mask and the flux that's already in the paste. right. Now this little button here, I'll just do by hand also. So I just put solder on one of the pads. Okay, and do the same thing we did with the controller. Just put it on there. And just solder it in one of the legs so that it can keep it in place. And then just solder the other three legs. Alright, now we gotta do the diodes. Okay, so I'm basically just going to do the same thing with the diodes that I did with all the other components. Just add solder paste to all the pads. Place the diodes on and then just use the hot air to solder it. Okay, now I'm just gonna dump all the diodes onto here. Okay, this is probably the most tedious part, is just placing all the diodes on. Here. And this part always takes the longest for me. Okay, and the orientation of the diode does matter. But it doesn't have to be perfect. Because when you solder it on with the hot air, the tension from the solder will just pull it in place. So when I'm putting it on, it does not have to be perfect. Alright, now I'm just going to solder it up with hot air. Okay, so there were a couple of them that just fell off while I was doing it, so just gotta put it back on. Alright, I took a break for a couple hours, and now let's just finish up the rest. The only thing really to do is to finish this, solder in this resistor right here. And it can actually be mounted on either side because this is a double-sided board. So I'm just going to bend the legs, insert it through. You know what I like to do is I always clip the leads before I solder. Okay, this little cutter here, what it does is when you clip the leads, it leaves just a tiny bit sticking out so that you can solder the rest. Okay, so it's pretty much done. All right, let me just show you the soldering up close. Here's the main stuff right here. Right, now it's done, so we'll just ruin it with water. I'm just kidding, by the way. This is isopropyl alcohol to clean up off all the flux. Alright, so let me put the camera back. And what I'm using to clean is 99% isopropyl alcohol. You can't really buy that at any stores. Here, let me just show you. This is the stuff I got. And since it's almost pure, it should dry off pretty fast. And the wipes that I'm using is Kim wipes. It doesn't leave any fibers. Here's the one resistor. Okay, so one thing that does need to be modified is the C3 capacitor right here. It gets in the way of the case. Let me just show you. So this guy right here, it's gonna get in the way of the case when you try to mount it. So we have to modify the case. Okay, let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay, when you mount it like this, this capacitor right here gets in the way of this little plastic thing sticking up. So all I have to really do is take a Dremel and then drill this part right here. And I already measured it and I marked it. So if you're doing this, let me see. Yeah, it's about 9 millimeters away from this little groove right here. See, when you mount it like this, this part here will get in the way. So I'm just gonna drill that out. Let's see, where is it right here? All right, that should be good enough. All right, now let me just test the fit. Yeah, so now it sits flush. Looks like that did it. Alright, so all the soldering is done and it's cleaned up. Now I'm just going to make sure all the connections are good. Basically, I'm just going to do a continuity test. Alright, so that's good. Now, let's load the firmware into the keyboard so then we can test all the if all the keys work. Alright, so I just flashed it and it should work now. Just gotta restart it. Okay, so here's how I'm gonna test it. Everything is right. I'm just gonna short the switch contacts, and then it should activate the key. Alright, so everything looks good. Okay, let me just show you real fast. And it looks like this one works fine. So it looks like everything is ready and ready to be shipped off. Alright, so I got a couple more to solder and build. And that's about it.